Hello there, I've got another reading for you today, a three stack card reading with lucky numbers for the lotteries to follow every reading. So I'll give you three stacks to choose from, and it's a short reading, so if you choose one, two or three, one, two and three. So there you have stack one, stack two, stack three. Don't go away without your lucky numbers, they could make you a millionaire. This time next week you could be a millionaire. Choose number one, two or three, think about what you'd like to know about your love life, etc. It's mainly a love reading, and we're going to cover the next few weeks. So pick one, two or three. You pick two of them if you want, or all three if you want. You can have whatever you want. Let's take a look at number one. If you chose number one, this is for you. My name's David Charles, international psychic medium, master of witchcraft. I'm the UK's leading psychic, I believe, and master of witchcraft, and I do witchcraft spells and psychic readings and all that. Go to my website, you'll see them. And it's davidcharlespsychic.com. Now, the first card we have is the Queen of Cups and Spilt Cups. Yeah, interesting. If any of you know what this means, you may be ahead of me. The Queen of Cups, beautiful. A love card, it's a love reading. The cups are the hearts in an ordinary deck of cards. So this is like a heart cup. The Queen of Cups, a bit like, I always think of Princess Diana. A super beautiful girl inside, may not be outside, but I think she probably is. Beautiful inside, she is spiritual, she's very spiritual, she's very into this kind of thing. It could be someone you know, or I may be thinking about you. Are you the Queen of Cups? She probably has fair hair, but not essentially, but she will be very into peace, tranquility, calmness, possibly healing, possibly ritual work or witchcraft, something like that. You may know this person. If it's not you, let me know in the comments. Let me know if you know her, because she's coming your way and she's very important. Especially if you're looking for advice on love. It could be your new girlfriend, or it can sometimes indicate a man, but this is, for most of you, this is a lady heading your way soon. Look out for her, she's very attractive. Well, she's attractive from the heart, so she may not look any different to anyone else, but chances are she's beautiful inside. You should meet her very soon if you don't know her already. Then you have this one. You can see the cups there have fallen over. And the man is sort of cloaked in depression. Depression is not a word I like to use, but it can mean sadness. So it can also mean tears, and tears can be symbolic. It can mean crying over spilt milk. Have you been crying over spilt milk? Are you wishing you could go back and change something, number one? You can't do that. You can learn from it. You can apologize for it, but you can't undo it. If you need to apologize for it, or you can be sorry to yourself. But if you're going back in time, or wishing you could go back, you can't change anything now, but you can learn from it and change the future. You won't change all of your future, a lot of it's preordained, but some of the things you can do, especially when you have a psychic reading, is avoid negatives that are predicted. So if I said to you, you're gonna lose your handbag in Harrods in London, you'd make sure you didn't. And you can avoid some negatives, but you won't avoid everything. Psychic readings, a message from the spirit world, and of course they can be warnings for you as well. So don't get crying over spilt milk. Don't get crying at all, because it won't help really. If tears have to come, then they have to come, but don't cry unnecessarily, and don't get crying over spilt milk during the next week or two. The third card is the Hanged Man, this chap there, hanging upside down from the Major Arcana. And this can mean, well, it does mean, you probably haven't had it easy recently. You may not have had it easy all your life. But the Hangman indicates that things are improving, that you're about to get paid back for some of the sacrifices you've made in the past, some of the tough things you've been through, some of the hard times you've been through. And it appears to me that you've had a hard time, but you've always made sure that you help other people, which is good. It's a good thing to do, but you've got to look after yourself as well. This card indicates that you're about to be rewarded for all the rubbish you've put up with in the past. Let me know in the comments down there. And it means you deserve it. You deserve to be rewarded. The spirit world, the powers that be, and karma will make it up to you if you've had a tough time. So look at this. You have the Queen of Cups, the Queen of Love, the Queen of Hearts. As I said, it's hearts in an ordinary deck. Some maybe sadness around you, But it shouldn't last long because things looking, you know, picking up the reading altogether. Things are picking up for you. And if you're feeling sad at the moment, it won't last long. So look forward to the future and don't look at the past if you can help it too much. You can't help it always, I know. And when you're on these, what are they called, social media sites and the memories pop up from the past, I always say they're lovely, but some of them can hurt. So don't let that hurt you either. And you're going to get rewarded for some of the rubbish you put up with in the past. I'll give you some lucky numbers in a minute, a bit later on in the reading. So stick with me. Don't go without your lucky numbers. They can make you a millionaire. If you chose number 2, and you pick this one here, let's take a look. Swords. Swords here we have, sticking in this chap's back. Swords are the spades in an ordinary deck of cards, and they are sticking in this bloke's back because people are backstabbing, and this can include you. If you chose number 2, there could be backstabbing around you, there could be people around you that are not true behind your back. They may be lovely to your face. Don't get paranoid, but just don't tell people all of your business. And if you're a girl, don't tell girls your business, don't tell women your business, because they can sometimes get a bit jealous. And they may be a bit naughty when you're not around. As I said, don't be paranoid, it's not everybody. Then you have the World card from the Major Arcana. The World card means the world is your oyster. It can mean travel, of course, but it usually means that the world is yours. Everything you want is there if you just see it, open your eyes and see it and start to live. Start to enjoy life for today. Again, I'll go back to what I said to number 1. Don't think of the past too much. Think of the nice bits from the past, but don't dwell on the mistakes and the memories. The world is your oyster. It can mean travel overseas. Let me know if you're travelling overseas. And let us know in the comments. I'll make some comments back if I get time. I usually do. But this is a good card for you, number 2. The world is your oyster. Remember, things are changing. And it can include money coming, so stick around for your lucky numbers. And then you have the Page of Pentacles. And Pentacles, of course, in an ordinary deck are the diamonds, and the pentacles in an ordinary deck, the diamonds in an ordinary deck don't have the page. You have Jack, Queen, King. You don't have a page. This is extra for the tarot. I don't know why there isn't one in the ordinary deck, but there isn't. This is a young person, most likely a man, heading your way. Could be a new lover. If someone's successful, he's bright, he's charismatic, and he's got a personality, which is nice. He's clever, he may be a bit arty, maybe a bit musical, he may like music, he may play music. But he's coming your way and he's got success written all over him. He's not very old, and if he is old, then he's young at heart. So you may know who that is. Let me know in the comments if you know who this person is. I may be picking up you. This person's heading your way. It's not necessarily a new lover, but it could be. If you're ready for a new lover, watch out for this person, because he's a classy person, he's a good person. Stick around for your lucky numbers, because they could make you very wealthy, as I said. So watch out for backstabbing, but don't be paranoid. Don't tell everyone all your business, and they can't use it against you. The world is yours for the taking. This is a very optimistic time from a very optimistic card. The world is yours. Don't miss out on it, and don't miss out on chances at the moment, because they're coming thick and fast. It may not seem that way today, but wait and see. You'll see that I'm right. And watch out for the page. He may bring news to you as well, by the way. And he's a good person. Stick around for your lucky numbers. I'll give you them in a minute. And if you chose number 3, take a look at number 3. Ah. Right, we have swords here again. Look at the clouds in the background. The swords, as I said, are spades. In the ordinary deck, this shows conflict. You can see the people walking away. It may be that you've been in conflict in the past and you've been at the wrong end of it and probably been defeated. But this also can mean arguments and bickering to come soon. And it means the spirit world, always the same. If the spirit world predict arguments, it means avoid them, because you won't win an argument. You'll be wrong even if you're right. Don't get involved in arguments at the moment, or fights or anything like that. I know in America you call arguments fights. But don't get involved in arguments, because you'll lose. And don't get involved in other people's arguments either, because you can't win and you'll probably get dragged into it, and you don't need that. Let me know what you think in the comments. Then you have this chap here, travelling person. Travels all over the place. Maybe linked to your career or your earthly life rather than romance. Earthly life means the way you live, the way you earn your living and that sort of thing. It can be romantic, but I don't think so. The reason I say that is because this man heading your way is a bit of a flirt and he likes the ladies. So if it's someone you fancy and you like, don't fall in love with him because he could deceive you. And of course it could be a lady as well. It doesn't have to be a chap. This person's flirty, a womanizer. If it's a lady, she may be flirty with the chaps. Good person, a great person, a great friend, especially if you work with them, but not suitable for falling in love with, really. Let me know in the comments what you think. The third one is a chariot from the Major Arcana. See, the horses, or pharaohs, whatever you want to call them, are pulling that chariot in two directions. One is trying to go one way, the other is trying to go the other way, slightly going that way. It means you're being pulled apart, and you're being pulled in two directions, and you're trying to be in more than one place at a time, or you're trying to help all the people all of the time, and you can't do that. Number three, you can't please all the people all the time, so don't try to. And it can mean that you have an imbalance with your yin and yang as well. Look at it again. Yin and yang, the energies that flow through us, if they're out of balance, it can make you feel pulled all over the place, like you're trying to be in 10 places at once. It can make you feel that you're not sleeping well. It can cause stress, and it's caused by stress, so you get the vicious circle going on. So watch out for a yin and yang problem, and it's probably because you're trying too much, you're trying to please everybody all the time, and you can't do that, so don't try. But you've got some good stuff here. It's not all doom and gloom. Don't argue, because you've avoided that now, hopefully. Don't get into arguments, especially other people's arguments. Don't fall in love with this person. It could be a man or a woman, but for most of you, it will be a man. And stop trying to please all the people all the time. You'll never do it. And if you do, they won't thank you for it, a lot of them, anyway. Lucky numbers time. These lucky numbers have been chosen by me with my spirit guides a few minutes ago before I started filming. These lucky numbers could change your life. You can use all, I'm going to give you six each. You can use all six or just a couple of them and some of your own. Mix them up a bit, because if you all use the same numbers and you all win the jackpot, you won't get very much each. So use some of mine and some of yours. If you chose number one today, your lucky numbers are 1, coincidentally, 17, 23, 32, 38, and 46. Give me again. 1, 17, 23, 32, 38, and 46. Do they ring any bells? Could be birthdays or wedding days, anniversaries. The day you got married, the day you had your baby, maybe. If you chose number 2, remember, gamble responsibly if you're gambling. Don't get overdoing it. If you chose number 2, your lucky numbers today are 10, 28, 29, 39, 43, and 45. Do they ring any bells? Let me know in the comments. That's 10, 28, 29, 39, 43, and 45. I can see one of you getting rich out there. Let me know if you hit the jackpot. If you chose number 3, your lucky numbers for today are 9, 17, 21, 33, 46, and 50. So that's 9, 17, 21, 33, 46, and 50. Let me know if they mean anything to you. A lot of you will. Use some of mine, some of your own, and mix them up a bit. And let me know when you win the jackpot. Or if you win anything, it's nice to know. A lot of people do, and they let me know. Sometimes privately, sometimes on the comments below. Remember, if you'd like a psychic reading with me, go below, it's davidcharlespsychic.com, or one of my team, and I have over 120 psychics that work for me, and they're all good, or they wouldn't be working for me. So, it's davidcharlespsychic.com, or David Charles Psychic Limited, that's my limited company. And you can get a reading with me on there, on the top of the homepage, or a reading with my team 24 hours a day. They're waiting for you on the phone right now. Please subscribe and give it a like and all that stuff, and share this with your friends. Give them a chance and share it with your best mates. And as I said, be careful, some of you, for jealousy. There's a bit of that jealousy in one of these readings, a bit of backstabbing. Lovely to see you all. Wherever you are in this beautiful world, remember my motto. Think lucky and you'll be lucky. Think love and you'll be loved. And I love every single one of you. Take it easy. See you soon. And I'll catch you later.